In this video, we'll be connecting Claude and Notion to create an agentic workflow. Time is finite and we value yours, so let's jump straight into it. Now, you might have seen demo videos of large language models trying to interact with other apps, but for the longest, all they really did was add text to a file. But now we actually have a working system that allows Claude to programmatically interact with your Notion workspace, creating new items, databases, and structuring information completely autonomously. A true AI agent working alongside with you. Step one, download Node.js. Head over to this website to download and install Node.js on your computer. Because this MCP server is a JavaScript-based application, you need to have Node.js installed on your computer before proceeding to the next step. Links for everything will be included in the description below. Step two, GitHub Notion MCP server. Connect to a Notion MCP server. Head over to GitHub and save this code here. Once configured, Claude will automatically pull in and run this MCP server using an npx command. Step three, Notion integration. The next major step is setting up the actual connection with your Notion workspace. Navigate to your Notion profile, which you can find at notion.so/profile. Once we're here, we're gonna head over to integrations and we're gonna set up a new integration. We're gonna name it MCP test right there. We're going to associate it with the workspace. We're going to keep this internal for privacy purposes. And then we're going to hit save. Integration successfully created. Now let's configure this. Now that we've created the integration, you'll get a secret API key. This is extremely important and you need to copy this secret key and paste it into Claude's configuration later. This token is what authenticates the connection between Claude and your Notion workspace. Now let's talk about permissions. By default, this integration will have the capability to read content. However, to build a second brain effectively, you'll want Claude to be able to create and modify your workspace. So you also want to enable update and insert content permissions. With the Notion side ready, let's configure Claude Desktop. If you haven't already, make sure you download the Claude Desktop application. This is where we tell Claude about the MCP server and provide that secret token. So let's go up here onto the left-hand corner. We're gonna hit File, Settings, and then here you'll see the Developer tab. We're gonna click Edit Config, and here you'll see the Claude Desktop config file, which we'll be editing. Let's open the file. Here I'm using VS Code to open the editor, but you can use a simple notepad. Now let's head over to GitHub and we're going to copy this code here. We're going to go to the editor and we're going to insert the code. Now we're going to head back over to Notion and we're going to copy our secret API key. Back to our editor, and here where it says Notion API token, we're gonna replace this here. Once we have that, we're going to save our file. Now reopen Claude Desktop, and you should see a new tool icon appear indicating that Notion is available. Now, sometimes this doesn't work for me, and I have to go back to the application and reinstall Claude Desktop. And I find that that usually gives me a hard reset. Now that we've set up the integration and configured Claude, there's one more step mandated by Notion. Your MCP integration does not automatically have access to all your pages. Notion adds an extra layer of security requiring you to explicitly grant permission on specific pages. It's pretty simple. Go to the specific Notion page you want Claude to be able to see or modify. Go to the three little dots, hover down to connections, and then here we'll type in MCP. We'll click MCP and then click confirm, allowing this MCP access to the Notion workspace. This is where your agentic workflow begins. Let's put Claude to the test using this video as an example. So here I have the Notion video template that I used to make this video, along with Claude Desktop on the side so you can see them work side by side. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab the script to this video, and then we're gonna have Claude create B-roll ideas. Can you create B-roll ideas for this video? I'm gonna paste in the script and have it generate us some B-roll ideas. All right, perfect. Now, what I like to do is copy the URL and then give it to Claude so that it can access the databases inside of this webpage. And here we have a database that sometimes I use to track B-roll ideas, and it gives me a list of what I can shoot. There it is, it's getting to work. You see, normally when I was doing this before, I would have to individually come in and then copy and paste every single one. And it also definitely didn't give me granular information like this here. So depending on the columns you have in your database, this will do a lot of the heavy lifting for you. Like I said, truly mind-blowing. 100% an AI workflow. And there we have it. Now you have an AI assistant for your Notion workspace. If you found this video helpful, please give the video a like and consider subscribing for more AI and productivity insights. And if you're interested in turning Claude into a super agent, check out our playlist where I connect various MCPs and create an agentic workflow to fall deeper into the matrix.